There are currently a lot of ways to install Facebook, or now called the Metapixel, on your WordPress website. In this video, I'll cover how to install pixels using Google Tag Manager. But before that, let me tell you what is the role of pixels. The Facebook pixel is a piece of code that you put on your website that allows you to measure effectiveness of your advertising by understanding the actions people take on your website. You can use the pixels to make sure that your ads are shown to right people. You can track events like page view, add to cart, purchases, etc. with the help of Facebook pixels. In this video, we will install the base code on our website which will pass a page view event to Facebook every time someone visits the website. For this method of Facebook pixel installation, you need to have Google Tag Manager installed on your WordPress website. And if you don't have it, then keep watching, else skip the part where I explain how to install the Facebook pixels by checking out the timestamp below. Again, there are a lot of ways to install Google Tag Manager as well on the WordPress, and I'm going to cover the one I feel is the simplest. Log in or create an account on Google Tag Manager. Then you will see the create account. Click on the same and fill in the details. Then go to WordPress admin section and hover over plugins and click on the add new. In the search bar on the next page that appears, type Google Sitekit. Install it and then you will see it in the left panel. Click on it and log in through the same account you made your Google Tag Manager with. Give all the access it wants, then go to the settings inside the Sitekit. Here you'll see the Google Tag Manager option. Open it and choose the account and the container you made while creating the account on Tag Manager. That's it. Now download the Google Tag Assistant extension for your Chrome browser and check if everything is installed properly or not. Now let's move on to setting up pixels. Open your Facebook account and let's set up the pixels. Now there are two ways how you can create pixels for your new ad account. The first is by creating a campaign with a conversion objective. When you will reach to ad set, the Facebook will ask you to create a pixel. Another one is by clicking on the event manager, then clicking on the connect data source, then tick the checkbox web and finally clicking connect. In the next option, choose Facebook pixel, then click connect, then read all of it and press continue. Now name your pixel and fill in your website for easy setup options, which I am not going to use, but I just wanted to show you. Then you can select the partner integration and automatically Facebook will install the pixel on your website for you. But since we don't want that, so I won't show how to properly do that. I don't do so because it restricts a lot of option for us. With the method that I am telling you, we will be able to customize a lot of things. Now go to the settings and copy the pixel ID. Now open your Google Tag Manager account. If you have a lot of accounts like me, then choose the one that you installed on the website. Sanidhya Baweja is the one that is relevant to me right now. Clicking on the same will take you to this screen. Click on the new tag and then you will see this screen. Then click on tag configuration and you will be presented with a lot of predefined templates. You can either install the full code in the header and footer or header body of your page by using the HTML tag, which involves a bit of coding knowledge and some knowledge, or you can use these templates to do the same. These make installing the code pretty simple. You need to just know the details like pixel ID, and these templates will take care of coding themselves for you. As a marketer, we use Google Tag Manager for two main reasons. First is to curb the dependency on the tech team so that you can get a lot of things installed on the website without help of the tech team. And second is to avoid the complex coding. Now there are a lot of officially predefined templates and Facebook template is not available over there. But then Google also allows us to use third party templates. Luckily, the Tag Manager community is very active and people have already made a template of Facebook over here. Choose this particular template, click on add to workspace, then click add, then insert your Facebook pixel ID in the dialog box, then choose a standard event name page view, because that's what we are doing. By doing this process, you are basically letting Facebook know every time someone visits any page on your website, they will know. Then click on triggering, which is used to set up a trigger. Now you will say, what is a trigger? Trigger is a certain action which someone performs and because of that a tag is fired. Over here I already mentioned the trigger is when someone visits a page, and then a page view tag will be fired, and that will finally tell Facebook that someone has viewed the page on the website. You can create a lot of triggers, like if someone spends 15 seconds then you want a trigger, or if someone clicks on add to cart, and a lot more. I'll cover this in detail in the next video where I'll teach you how to set up conversion events. Now select all the pages because you want it to trigger on every page, and the type of this trigger is page view. That's it. Name your tag. Give it a name which will help you identify the changes that you made in this particular tag. Finally, save this tag. Now click on the preview. You will be taken to a screen, and over here enter the URL of your website. This will take you to your website to test the desired changes. Now let me clarify that this is a test environment that GTM has created for you. The changes are not yet live on the website. This is a test environment and is created only on your browser to test the changes before pushing everything live. Now to test this, install Facebook Pixel Helper in your browser and then click on the same, and you will find out that a page view is firing. It shows an error in mine because I already had a pixel on the website, so it fires twice, I guess, and that's the error. I need to make a few changes, and that's how it works. You can install as many pixels on a website as you want, but I would not suggest that. It will only make your website slow. That's it, so don't do it. Now that we have made sure that pixels are working fine, it is time to push these live to our website. Now press the submit and give this version a name and a description which will help you understand what went live later on. Just a GTM info here. These versions are there to revert the whole thing without damaging anything. If you feel that something is wrong after you push the changes, then you can immediately go back to the previous version and revert the changes. In the next video, I'll teach you how to set up standard and custom conversion events on Facebook. Also, this video was a part of Facebook course on how to run Facebook ads, and you can access the whole full course over here by clicking over here. Go ahead, check out the full course if you haven't already. Until next time, bye bye.